Hey, OBS friends, happy week three of our Pointing to the Promise online study. It's been an honor to walk through the last 2 weeks with you, and I look forward to another week of digging into God's Word together. Advent has officially begun. Now, many of you may not know what Advent is or even celebrate it, and that's okay. We would love to invite you to a night of light with OBS tonight at 8 o'clock Eastern Time on our OBS Facebook page. At this virtual event, I'll share a message on Advent, and then we'll spend time in worship together. I think you'll enjoy this time to simply rest and receive after pouring out so much. Guess what time it is? Time to hear another wonderful message from our author, Kayla Ferris. This week, our focus is the word faithfulness. Deuteronomy 7:9 tells us our God is a faithful God. He is faithful even when we don't see or feel Him moving or acting on our behalf. Kayla, what do you say to the woman who may be struggling with hanging on when she wants to let go? I'm really excited you're spending time this week focusing on Mary. What can we learn from Mary to help us stay faithful when it's hard?
Hi, friends. Well, if there was ever someone to look to as an example for faithfulness, Mary is a great place to start. Mary gets a visit from an angel, which the scriptures say caused her to become greatly troubled. You know, she's going to give birth to the Messiah, God's own son. Can you imagine that kind of responsibility? And then she had to explain all of this to her fiancé, who had every legal right to stone her if he wanted, because he would have thought her unfaithful. So yes, this is the greatest honor ever given to a woman, but don't think it didn't come with a ton of questions and hardships. So how was Mary able to remain so very faithful? And I think we find the answer to that in her song that we're going to be looking at this week. You can find this in Luke 1:46. And in it, it says, "And Mary said, my soul magnifies the Lord." This word magnify, it means to make larger, to give a place of importance. So to magnify the Lord means that you have to see God as bigger and more important than your problems. You know, I once heard it said that our problems are like this quarter, and God is the sun. And we can hold our problems so close to our eye that we completely block out the sun. So our first step towards greater faithfulness is that we must magnify the Lord. We must realize that He is bigger and greater and more powerful, and that our problems are tiny in comparison. Second, Mary says in Luke 1:49, "For He who is mighty has done great things for me, and holy is His name." See, Mary remembered. She recalled God's faithfulness to her in the past. "He has done great things for me," which means He's going to continue to do great things. He's going to continue to be present. Bible scholar Dale Davis said, "Amnesia produces apostasy." In other words, we lose faith when we forget, which tells me we have to be very intentional about remembering what God has done for us. So that's going to be our moment of reflection for this week. I want to encourage you to take a note card or a piece of paper, and I want you to write down all the ways that God has been good and faithful to you in the past. You know, when I did this activity myself, I was amazed at how once I got started, like, they just started flooding to my mind, and my hand was writing as fast as I could. So once you have your list, at the bottom, I want you to date it. Write the year, 2021. Now, that exercise alone will stir up your faith. But what I want you to do is I want you to go to your Christmas decoration tub or boxes or closet, and I want you to put this note in there. Just hide it away. You know, when you take your Christmas decorations down, it'll be there. And the next Christmas, when you're going to pull out your decorations, you're going to find it. And you're going to be like, "Oh yeah, I remember doing this. Wow, God has been really faithful to me." And then I want you to add to the bottom all the ways that God has been faithful to you in 2022. And He will be, I promise. Date it. hide it again. In 2023, you pull out your Christmas decorations, and guess what? Here it is again, and you are reminded, wow, God is good to me. And you know, that gives me the faith to walk into a new season or a new year, because I know God will be faithful to me again. So my prayer this week is that you will be flooded with memories of God's faithfulness to you, and enjoy writing those down, friends.
I don't know about you, but Kayla already has me looking forward to pulling out my decorations next year to see this list. What a fun activity to remember God's faithfulness. Kayla, thank you. All right, friends, let's get to it. Week 3 has officially begun. Remember, when you know the truth and live the truth, it changes everything. Bye.